we were discussing this at our meeting this morning. The bottom line is that there are a range of NET tumours. Some are non-functioning, and if they're non-functioning, if you're having an intervention, you're at no risk of having a carcinoid crisis. The group of patients that are at risk of having a carcinoid crisis are the patients who have carcinoid syndrome. Now, most people with carcinoid go on to the long-acting somatostatin injections once a month. The real risk of carcinoid crises occurs if you're having a kind of a significant intervention. It shouldn't happen for minor with very minor procedures, but those patients who have a carcinoid syndrome who are going for a procedure in hospital, or I don't know what the situation we discussed, dental procedures this morning, so at what level, patients who are going for a hospital-based procedure or a procedure that's going to involve an anaesthetic and have the syndrome, so are already on their treatment for flushing, they need an add-on, they need a boost to cover the 24 hours around the procedure. And that's an important treatment, and it's an important thing to make the medical profession aware of, because you'll be going to somebody who won't necessarily be dealing with NETs on a day-to-day basis. So having that information to give them, to say this is what I need, is important. And you can't really give it the day before the procedure, because it will take some time, often 48 hours, to get the octreotide tied in and set the infusions up. So it isn't for all NET tumours, and there are situations where, if you have, say, for example, a pancreatic NET, where an octreotide infusion can be a bad thing. So it's not across the board, should we all have it, because if it's good for them, it might be good for me. The group that will need this are the group that have carcinoid syndrome and are having a hospital-based procedure. Now, who wants to add or subtract from that?
Just as a kind of rule of thumb, I think if you're having a procedure that needs a general anaesthetic, you probably should be having prophylactic octreotide. So if even at something like a wrist fracture manipulation or something, a procedure of that scale can sometimes precipitate a carcinoid crisis if you're prone to it. But you certainly don't want to have the treatment if you don't need it. I mean, it does have downsides.
There's very little data. There's very little collective research on carcinoid crisis. And if you have carcinoid syndrome, I think Justin Gagan's comment was very good, that if in doubt, better to treat. So, if you're having your wisdom tooth pulled, should you? I don't know. Usually that's a fairly, non-traumatic event now. Maybe back in the 1950s, you probably should have had an infusion of octreotide, but by and large, I think for most people don't have anything if they're having a liver biopsy, because that's at a stage perhaps even before you've made the diagnosis. But it's very hard to know and predict who will have a carcinoid crisis. You can imagine that if you opened up the tummy and you were resecting out tumors in the liver, that this patient definitely should, or the primary tumor. But there you gave an example of something completely unrelated, where your body was completely stressed at the time and your reaction was unpredictable and you had a respiratory crisis. So I think, and I've seen a number of patients like that as well. It's rare, but it's preventable. So I think that if you have the chance, like you said, to be awkward about signing the consent and give us a ring, and if we can help you out, we certainly will. I think having the cards will be useful, for sure.